biology.
So welcome again to this next class, where today we are going to continue on our nutrition topic. So today we are going to discuss on the leaf. So let's look at the external structures of the leaf, and we are going to begin with the lamina. So what is the lamina? This is the flat and the green parts of the leaf. So it mainly contains chlorophyll, or the photosynthetic tissue. So the first, the second part of the leaf, we are going to look at the midrib. So what's the midrib? This is a thick structure that runs along or across the leaf. So the next one, we are going to look at the veins. So the vein, they arise from the midrib and they connect every tissue of the leaf with the necessary nutrients. So again, let's look at the next part, whereby we are going to look at the apex. So apex, this is the part of the leaf where it's mostly pointed, the pointed tip of the leaf rather. So lastly, let's look at the petiole. So this is the part of the leaf that attaches the leaf to the stem, or the leaf to the branch. So in monocotyledonous plant, we don't have a petiole, but in the monocotyledonous plants, we have a sheath. So in the monocot plants, we have a sheath. In the dicot plants, we have a petiole. So that was all about the external structures of the leaf. Now let's look at the internal structures of the leaf and see what it is made up of. So first of all, we are going to begin from the topmost part. We have the cuticle, where this is the transparent layer of the leaf that mainly protects the internal parts of the leaf. It is also transparent in that it allows light to penetrate to the internal structures of the leaf. Also, the cuticle is waxy, which prevents excess water loss by the leaf to the environment. So the next part after the cuticle, we have the epidermis, which is mainly one cell thick. It comprises of many dead cells. So we have an epidermis on the upper parts of the leaf and the lower parts of the leaf. So the epidermis is the one responsible for secreting the cuticle. And we must know that it does not have a chloroplast, but it might have guard cells. So let's look at the next one. After the epidermis, we have the palisade mesophyll cells, or the palisade layer. Now the palisade layer, it comprises of cylindrical cells, or cylindrical-like cells, which mainly have the chloroplast. So these cells are closely packed together and they have the chloroplast. And as you can see, they are found on the upper parts of the leaf. We are going to see on that on the later subtopics. Then we have now the spongy mesophyll and the palisade mesophyll, which mainly comprises of cells that have very large air spaces between them for gaseous exchange and for the trapping of carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. So in the spongy mesophyll, we also have the vascular bundles. What's the function of the vascular bundles? We have the xylem and the phloem. The xylem function is to conduct water and mineral salts through the leaf. The phloem function is to conduct the manufactured food substances throughout the leaf, maybe to the other parts of the plant. So let's finish up by looking at the adaptations of the leaf to its function. So let's begin with the previous point. We say that it contains xylem and phloem. Their function is to transport substances within the leaf. Xylem transports water and mineral salts, while phloem transports or conducts food substances. Then it has the leaf has a broad flat lamina for trapping of excess, or for maximum trapping of the sunlight. Then we see that the leaf also have a very thin cuticle. The function of thin cuticle is to allow maximum sunlight to penetrate through, so as to reach the internal structures of the leaf. Then also we see that the leaf is very thin. So why is the leaf very thin? So the leaf is very thin for easier diffusion of gases throughout the leaf structure. So also we see that the palisade cells, as I had mentioned, they are located on the upper parts of the leaf. What's the function? So as to be able to be in contact with first-hand sunlight rays for maximum photosynthesis. Also we see that these palisade cells, they have maximum chloroplast in them. What's the function of the palisade cells having chloroplast? For maximum manufacture of food, since chloroplast manufacture the plant food. Also, the palisade, the spongy mesophyll rather, they have very large air spaces. What did we say the function is? For the maximum trapping of carbon dioxide or other gases which are responsible for photosynthesis. Then we see that the cuticle is also waxy and waterproof. What's the function? So as to prevent excess water loss by the plant. Then we have leaf mosaic. Leaf mosaic simply means that there is no leaf overlapping over the other. So this leaf will be exposed to sunlight on its own, as this leaf will be exposed on its own. So no leaf is on top of the other to prevent the other leaf from absorbing sunlight. Then lastly, we have the guard cells. So the leaf has guard cells which control the opening and closing of the stomata. So that was the internal structures of the leaf. Now let's meet on the next class as we continue more on the nutrition in plants as well. Biology.